One of the things that I really like about the keto diet book is, and just Leanne's philosophy, the number one thing that she says is to listen to your body and learn your body. And that's super important, I believe, because only you and God knows what your body needs. So this might not work for everybody. I'll just put that out there. But if you're dealing with insulin issues or blood sugar problems, IBS problems, high cholesterol, I would say it might work. And don't knock it till you try it. That's probably my number one thing is, I would prefer for someone to say, you know, I have not heard about that before, or that's an interesting way to eat. Not, you're gonna die, you're gonna have a heart attack, you're gonna have a stroke. Because you don't know that. There's lots of research that has gone behind this type of eating. There's lots of different benefits to eating a low carb, high fat eating plan. So the thing that's cool about the keto diet, her particular way of explaining things, is that you can have what they call carb ups or carb cycling. And so what you would do briefly, I have another video that explains this fully, and her book explains it much better than I do, but you can eat low carb for the most part, and then if there's, you know, an opportunity for you to do a carb up, like at night, you can, instead of eating the higher fat, you can replace that fat ratio with having carbs. Now, does that mean that you junk out on pizza and ice cream? Personally, for me, not a good idea. I think that would send my blood sugar all over the place and my tummy. I haven't had wheat in forever. So if I were to have that, it probably wouldn't be a good thing. And you might think, oh, do I have to live without wheat forever? It's not a terrible thing, I don't think. And I'll do another video and probably a blog post about how it has helped my digestion. I can't even begin there because it would be too long, but so yeah, I can live without wheat. I don't even want it anymore. So she has some different ways to do that in here, and easy to understand, lots of graphs, lots of charts, lots of lists, some recipes, just kind of an all-encompassing book. And like I said, like, I've studied this thing. I love it. I just love that God allows us to heal our bodies with food. Imagine that. And there's so many people, like, our state is tied for number two in the whole nation. It's tied with three states, number two in obesity. And you know what we rank number one on? Super exciting, diabetes. Something's gotta change. So that brings me to the reason why I started this blog. Like I said before, you may think that this is not for you, and that is okay, because everybody has their own way of doing things. However, I do not want a little medication. I do not want to depend on the government to regulate what I have to take and how much I have to take and how much I have to pay for those things. Medical costs are skyrocketing. We can't afford to be sick. We literally cannot afford to be sick. So our family is trying to get a little healthier. One day at a time, one step at a time, one good decision at a time. So I started this blog as a way to put information out there. I know there's tons of blogs out there. I get it. And a lot in this space. But I wanted to bring the information that I've learned, the resources that I have found helpful, and just try to put it all in one place, if for nobody else but me. However, I think it's valuable. I think the information that's out there is valuable, and there's lots of people that know a lot about a ketogenic lifestyle and how it's helped different things. I mean, they are talking about how it can help with Alzheimer's. I mean, that is a huge, huge problem. They are talking about how it doesn't necessarily cure cancer, but it can help stop the growth of cancer. Like, this is a big deal. And doctors aren't necessarily educated in how food can heal our body, because that is not necessarily in the best interest of the medical profession. I believe that there are people in the medical profession that their heart, their whole heart, is to help people. But a lot of times their hands are tied. Their hands are tied because of money, government regulations, you name it. However, we, the general population, can make choices about the food we eat. At this moment in time, we still have a choice to whether we eat junk or whether we can choose healthy foods. And I know that doesn't happen overnight, but it can happen. So I started this blog for that. And you'll notice that I also incorporate some sign language. I felt it was really important to not only get this education out to the hearing population, but also to the deaf population. These podcasts I'm listening to are phenomenal. There's just lots of really good information. And that's my heart's desire, is to get this out to the deaf community as well, if they want it. It's there, it's free for them to use or to not use. But I believe it's a lifestyle that can change your health for the better. And when I say change your health, I'm not just talking about your physical health. So much of our physical being influences the rest of our everything else. Our emotions, our spiritual beings, our mental. If I'm addicted to sugar, I am not thinking clearly. If my sugar is dropping, I can't think clearly. I can't necessarily be my best self, because my attitude changes very quickly. So this way of eating has given me so much energy. You could see inside my brain. So that you can know, like, I feel like my mind is so clear. It just doesn't feel all gobbledygook anymore. And because my body is not using sugar as fuel anymore, it's using fat. And it's using it just fine. Like, I get up every morning ready to go, and I don't really go to bed till I'm done for the day. And so I have lots of energy. So to me, it's just an amazing way to live. I feel better. My husband feels better. His health has gotten basically a 360 turnaround. It's just an amazing way of eating. So again, maybe not for you, but if you have blood sugar issues, if you have insulin issues, if you have cholesterol issues, if you have tummy issues, I'm telling you, think about it. Explore it a little bit. Just kind of dig around a little bit. For me, it's awesome. So I'll just end with saying, I'm not a doctor. I'm not pretending to be one. I'm just a girl traveling on this road, figuring out what nutritional ketosis means, figuring out how I can still have a little bit of carbs. And I still eat carbs. My carbs are in my vegetables. So it's not like I'm just eating bacon and cheese and hamburgers all day. Like, that is the furthest thing from what I'm doing. My diet consists mostly, if you look at the volume, vegetables with a little bit of meat and fat. And so I just eat enough fat to get full. And that's what my body runs on. And it's been an amazing journey. And I wanted to share that with you, and I wanted to be able to share this blog with you. So if you know of someone that's struggling, send them to the blog, and hopefully maybe some of the things that I have on here will be helpful to you. And if you have any questions, I'd be happy to try to help answer them, and if I can't, I will point you in the direction of some resources that maybe I find, or people that might have more answers. So thanks for watching. I know this was kind of long, but I appreciate you watching, and let me know what you think. Thanks.